In this video, we'll take a quick tour of the features of our latest Building Manager Online Advanced Reporting Software module. Navigate to the BMO website using your browser. While most current browsers will work, Google Chrome is the preferred choice. Other options may exhibit some formatting irregularities. From this screen, enter your user email and password to log in. This will take you to the main user management screen where you'll have easy access to the various properties and devices assigned to your user account. The advanced reporting solution includes all the features of the basic module, so we would encourage you to also view the separate basic module overview for more details of these features. The basic module overview covers the initial setup of the properties, devices, and points used throughout the BMO system, as well as the core dashboards, Vital Builder, and Consumption Report features. For the purposes of this overview, we're going to focus on the Building Manager Online Advanced Reporting Module features. Let's take a quick tour of some of these reports, starting with the Drift Analysis. The Drift Analysis report can be a great tool for energy managers to compare energy consumption between different periods of time. This can be a great way to spot anomalies and identify potential issues. From the menu on the left, select the device and data point to be analyzed. Set the date range for comparison. In this example, we're looking at hourly average samples over a 15-day period, comparing July 31st through August 15th, with the following 15 days from August 15th through August 30th. In the chart, you can see there is an obvious irregular spike in the data. Hovering over that point shows that this anomaly is between records 253 and 254. We can scroll down to those records in the table below, where we can see the data and timestamp information to determine when the event occurred. This sort of data can help identify potential issues with the system and energy-saving opportunities. The Kiosk Report is an easy way to fulfill the public display requirements of many of the energy codes. Kiosks can present any of the data points from your BMO system, so it may include the summary data from virtual points or detailed data from individual points. The various elements of the kiosk display are user-selected, so it can be customized to suit your particular needs. Customize the background with a picture of the building as shown here, or you can use custom graphics. Upload a company logo to be used. Select the specific data points to be displayed. Any data points in the system may be displayed on the kiosk. They can be shown as a line chart, an area chart, or a bar chart, and the background colors are also user selectable. Each kiosk has its own unique URL, so it runs completely independent from the rest of the BMO system. Use any internet-connected computer to browse to the kiosk URL. The display will run on its own, scrolling through the data cards continuously. This is an easy way to set up a public display in the lobby and should fulfill the requirements for public display for code compliance. Next, let's look at the two heat map options, starting with the daily heat map. The daily heat map shows the peak consumption for the selected device and data point for the month in a calendar view. The color coding on the calendar shows which days had the highest peak and at what time that peak occurred. In this example, it's easy to see that the peak usage is during the work week and the lighter days are on the weekends. If there's a particularly high peak, it may indicate an issue that's worthy of a deeper dive. The hourly heat map is similar, except that it presents the data in an hourly rather than daily summary. This view shows each hour of each day in the selected date range. Select the device point to be displayed and the date range. By default, the report will show the last 30 days. Changing the date range is as easy as selecting the beginning and ending dates from the calendar selector. After selecting the date range, click on the Generate button to update the report. This is a great tool to help spot anomalies in the data. It's easy to see hot spots and identify data points that may be worth investigating. For example, since we're looking at overall lighting demand, what lights were on all night on September 3rd and why? The tree map works well for campus properties with multiple buildings or departmental systems reporting. It provides a snapshot of all the major buildings and systems in a simple tree structure. The larger boxes indicate higher usage. Like the heat map, the color indicates whether the usage is higher or lower than the previous month. The After Hours Cost Report can be a quick and easy way to generate after hours billing data. It's also an excellent way to identify areas where something has been left on after hours. It all begins with selecting the device as well as the data points to be used for the total consumption and demand. Set the rates for both the totalizer and demand to calculate the costs. The date range also includes the time frame setting for after hours. Specific times are set for the beginning and ending time for after hours designations. With all the settings configured, click the Generate button to execute the report. The report returns the readings for each period, which are shown in a graph at the top and in the table below. As with most of the reports in BMO, it's easy to extract the data from the system. Both the graph and the table may be exported for use in external analytics or reporting. For after-hours billing, you can export the data directly to a CSV or Excel file. If you want to create a more comprehensive report that includes a variety of elements, the energy reports may be just what you need. These energy reports make it easy to combine data from your saved vitals and add text for explanation to create a nicely formatted report. The editor allows you to format headers and text elements, add vitals reports, and then save these reports to be run on demand. This is a simple example of a monthly summary report, which includes graphs from the saved vitals along with text boxes to provide explanation. Well, that was a quick tour of some of the key features of the BMO Advanced Reporting Module. I hope you found this overview helpful and informative. Please let us know if you have any questions or would like to schedule a more in-depth demonstration. Thanks for your time and interest, and we hope to hear from you soon.